We're still in the book of Acts, and we're moving backwards from Revelation all the way to Genesis, looking at some of my favorite sections of Scripture. And we have just looked at Pentecost and Peter's first message and the 3,000 that were saved. We're still in the first section, which is chapters 1 through 7, which is in Jerusalem, two-year period, AD 33 to 35. And we're coming up on verse 42 through 47, telling us what the apostles were doing with those that were being saved in the section where Peter had delivered his message and 3,000 were saved and they were added to the church. They were continually devoting themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to breaking of bread, and to prayer. Everyone kept feeling a sense of awe, and many wonders and signs were taking place through the apostles. And all of those who had believed were together and had all things in common. They began selling their property and possessions, and they were sharing them with all, as anyone might have need. Day by day, continuing with one mind in the temple and breaking bread from house to house, they were taking their meals together with gladness and sincerity of heart, praising God and having favor with all of the people. And the Lord was adding to their number day by day those who were being saved. Well, I have to say there must have been a Baptist church. Look at the order in which they were doing things. It says they were together in the apostles' teaching, to fellowship, and to the breaking of bread, and then finally to prayer. That would probably define a lot of Southern Baptist churches today. They might come for the teaching, but they're going to be there for the breaking of the bread, and prayer might be an add-on. Nevertheless, I think it's important to notice that they were of one mind and that they were sharing with one another as there was need, and also that they were praising God and having favor with all of the people. They were not looking down their spiritual nose at those that were not saved and that were not part of the church. They were trying to reach into their community. And as a result, the very last line, I think, in the verse 47 is a very appropriate one, and that is they were adding to their number day by day as people were being saved. I think the church that is studying God's word, that is having good quality fellowship, that is in prayer, that is praising God, and is having favor with the people around them, is going to continue to grow. Now, we got to be careful we don't get those things out of sequence. We don't want to have just favor with people around us with a social gospel. But if we're teaching the word of God, and that's what they were doing with the apostles' teaching, and the fellowship is based around that teaching and the time of prayer, then I believe that God will always add to his church. So I hope that you'll take a look at this passage of Scripture as a good model for a church, maybe putting prayer before the breaking of bread, but otherwise I think it's a pretty good model. And that's my thought for the day. God bless you and have a great day.